हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल रीड फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ हिस्ट्री दैट इज नेशनलिज्म इन इंडिया। इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल रीड अबाउट महात्मा गांधी एंड देयर मूवमेंट्स। सो लेट अस बिगिन दिस चैप्टर, हैव अ लुक ओवर द टॉपिक्स। द टॉपिक्स आर फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड वॉर, गांधी सत्याग्रह, फर्स्ट थ्री सत्याग्रह मूवमेंट, रॉलेट एक्ट एंड जलियांवाला बाग। Before starting this chapter, we will understand the meaning of nationalism. When anyone asks us about nationalism, what we say? We say we Indians, right? But does it mean just standing during the national anthem, or does it mean the Indian hosting a flag on Republic Day or Independence Day? A billion people of a country, how defines sense of collective identity? To answer these questions, we need to understand a very basic concept of nationalism in India. Nationalism means people to have their own identities, their own sense of belongings, their culture. This sense of processing a national identity was strengthened by new songs, new ideas, new symbols, and new icons. People belonging to different groups and classes came together to fight a common enemy. That is known as a nationalism. We will understand how the Indian National Congress brought Indians together, from the rich to the poor, from educated to the illiterate, from the young to old men. Women and children participated in the national movement and fought to free India from colonial rule. The First World War, it was in 1914 to between 1918, was a turning point in the history of Indian national movement. First of all, the war had created the economic problems for the Indians. The people had suffered under the burden of a war fought by the British against their enemies. India has financed the war expenditures by war loans, by paying increased taxes, custom duties, and a higher income tax. There was an alarm rise in prices between 1913 and 1918. Which made the common people suffer great hardships. People, especially in rural areas, were forced to enter the armed forces. Epidemic followed in a wake of famines. It was reported by the census of 1920, more than 13 billion people died due to the famines and the epidemics. All these hardships rise desire for freedom in India, and a new generation of nationalists began looking for a new mode of struggle to overthrow the British rule. Now a hero come to save us from this hardship. His name was Mahatma Gandhi. Mahatma Gandhi. We all know about Mahatma Gandhi. His full name was Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. He had already made a name for himself in South Africa. In his struggle against the racist government of South Africa, he had chosen a novel method of protestation. This is called Satyagraha. On his return to India in January 1915, he used the same weapon against the British. So what does mean by Satyagraha? What was Satyagraha? Satyagraha means holding on truth or truth force. It was a non-violent, non-cooperation against a government which was high-handed, oppressive and unjust. He turned his movement into the mass movement, strengthened the Congress organization, and worked for improvement in Indian society. His first satyagraha was Champaran movement. The first movement ऑफ महात्मा गांधी वॉज चंपारण सत्याग्रह. चंपारण अ डिस्ट्रिक्ट इन द नॉर्थ वेस्टर्न पार्ट ऑफ बिहार सफर अंडर द यूरोपियन इंडिगो प्लांटर्स द यूरोपियन प्रैक्टिसाइज ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ ऑपरेशन अगेंस्ट द वीक पीजेंट. पीजेंट वर फोर्स टू ग्रो इंडिगो ऑन एट लीस्ट 1/3 ऑफ देयर लैंड. गांधी जी अलॉन्ग विद डॉक्टर राजेंद्र प्रसाद स्टार्टेड अ कैंपेन और सत्याग्रह विच मीन अ नॉन वायलेंट नॉन कॉपरेशन प्रोटेस्ट अगेंस्ट द अनजस्ट प्लांटर्स. नेक्स्ट इज खेड़ा सत्याग्रह. द खेड़ा मूवमेंट वॉज डायरेक्टेड अगेंस्ट द गवर्नमेंट. इन 1918 देयर वॉज अ ड्रॉट इन खेड़ा डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ गुजरात. पीपल वर अफेक्टेड बाय क्रॉप फेलियर एंड प्लेग एपिडेमिक. द बॉम्बे गवर्नमेंट इंसिस्टेड ऑन एक्सट्रैक्टिंग इट्स लैंड रेवेन्यू. द लैंड रेवेन्यू रूल प्रोवाइडेड और द रिमिशन ऑफ लैंड रेवेन्यू इफ द क्रॉप फेल वॉज लेस देन 25% ऑफ द नॉर्मल. बट द गवर्नमेंट रिफ्यूज दिस रिमिशन ऑफ लैंड रेवेन्यू. गांधी जी विद द हेल्प ऑफ पीजेंट ऑर्गेनाइज अ सत्याग्रह. द गवर्नमेंट हैड टू एग्री टू देयर डिमांड्स ऑफ द पीजेंट इन द एंड. थर्ड वॉज मील वर्कर्स मूवमेंट. गांधी जी ऑल्सो स्टार्ट अ सत्याग्रह मूवमेंट अमंग द कॉटन मील वर्कर्स ऑफ अहमदाबाद ऑन इशू ऑफ वेज हाइक. गांधी जी वेंट ऑन अ हंगर स्ट्राइक. द मील ऑनर्स नेगोशिएट एन एग्रीमेंट. वर्कर्स गॉट अ 35% इंक्रीज इन वेजेस. तो दीज वर द थ्री सत्याग्रह मूवमेंट दैट रन बाय महात्मा गांधी इन इंडिया. नेक्स्ट सत्याग्रह वॉज रॉलेट एक्ट. एक्चुअली द ब्रिटिशर पास अ न्यू एक्ट. That was Rowlatt Act. It gave the government enormous power to suppose political agitation. All political prisoners could be kept in detention without trial for 2 years. Gandhi ji launched a non-violent movement against this act in 1919, which is famously called Rowlatt Satyagraha. He began with a Hartal on April 6. Rallies were organized. Workers went on strike in many cities. Shop, railway, workshop and factories were closed down. So these were the procession against the British Raj. Next, come to the Jallianwala Bagh. Actually, on 10th April, police fire on a peaceful procession in Amritsar. The British government claimed the martial law in Amritsar and handed over the city to General Dyer. On 13th April, the day of Baisakhi festival, a peaceful meeting was held in Jallianwala Bagh. A ground enclosed there on three sides, thousands of people gathered there for a peaceful protest against the British Raj. They did not know about the General Dyer ban on meetings and gatherings. General Dyer appeared at the meeting without any warning, ordered firing on the unarmed people. His soldier fired till they ran out of the ground. People had no weapon and they all exit was blocked by the general men's. 1,000 people were killed. Dire intention was strike terror in the heart of the people, especially the Satyagrahis. That all was about this chapter and Mahatma Gandhi's Satyagrahas. In this chapter, we read 4 Satyagrahas which run by Mahatma Gandhi in India. That were Champaran, Kheda, and Ahmedabad Satyagraha, then Rowlatt Act and incident of Jallianwala Bagh. I hope you all understand this chapter very well. Then in next part we will read about the non-cooperation movement and civil disobedience movement. Thank you.